Children, can you see me? Is audio and video clear? Is audio and video clear, children? Please confirm whether audio and video is clear. Okay, audio and video is clear. Let us start the class. How many people are there? Only 6 people are there. So nice. Very, very sincere. Right. I'll start the class. The topic of interest now is properties of matter. Children, it includes properties of both solids and fluids. Question number 1. A stress of 3.18 multiplied by 10⁸ Newton per meter square. They have given stress of value 3.18 multiplied by 10⁸ Newton per meter square is applied to a steel rod of length 1 meter. The length of the steel rod is what? 1 meter along its length. The stress is applied along its length, children. Okay. Now, when I say the rod is like this, and it's along its length, the force is applied along its length. The stress is applied along the length. Okay. Right. Its Young's modulus is given by Y will be equal to 2 multiplied by 10 power 11 again Newton per meter square, because the unit of Young's modulus will be the same as unit of stress. Young's modulus is stress by strain. Strain does not have any unit. Then the elongation produced in the rod will be in millimeter. In millimeter, they want the elongation. Delta L will be equal to dash in terms of millimeter. What is your Y, children? Young's modulus will be equal to stress divided by strain. What is stress, children? It is force by area. Force by area is called stress, and already stress value is being given there. We need not worry about. Multiplied by what is change, children? Change in length by original length. Change in length by original length. Delta L by L is called as your strain. Therefore, Y will be equal to, I can say, stress divided by delta L by L. Delta L by L will be equal to stress by Y. Delta L by L will be equal to stress divided by Y. We want the value of elongation, children. Therefore, delta L will be equal to stress divided by Y multiplied by L. That is equal to what is the value of stress, children? It is 3.18 multiplied by 10⁸. What is the value of Y, children? 2 multiplied by 10⁻¹. What is the value of length, children? They have given us 1 meter. Let us check the unit of length, children. It is 1 meter along its length. Correct. Therefore, your 3.18 divided by 2, it is 1.59 multiplied by 10⁻¹. 1.59 multiplied by 10⁻³ millimeter. And 10⁻³ meter is called millimeter, children. Therefore, delta I will be equal to 1.59 millimeter, because we know that 10⁻³ meter will be equal to what? 1 millimeter. 10⁻³ is 1 millimeter, and then the correct option, 10⁻³ will be equal to 1 millimeter, and then the correct option for the question number 1 is option D, 1.59 is the correct option for the question number 1. Question number 2. A wire is stretched through 1 millimeter by a certain load. Children, now it is stretched by 1 millimeter. Therefore, delta L will be equal to 1 millimeter. Again, I am going to convert in terms of meter, children. 1 multiplied by 10⁻³ meter. That is your delta L. Okay? Right. By a certain load. We don't know the load. Let me say the load is F. The force is F. Okay? Right. The extension produced in the wire of the same material with the double the length. Okay. The extension produced. Now here, it is the first case. The extension is so much. Okay. Now they are asking the extension produced in the same material. When I say same material, then what does it imply? Y is same, constant. Young's modulus will be remain same. The extension produced in the same material with double the length and double the radius. Given length doubled. They have given length doubled and radius again doubled. Radius again doubled. Children, length doubled and radius doubled. Okay, they want the extension. They want the extension in the new case. Now, what does it imply, children? Then the load is also constant. Your force or load, that is again a constant. We have got two parameter constants, children. Y is constant because same material. Load is constant. What is the bearing? length is varying and the radius is varying. Radius means area of cross section will vary. Now therefore y will be equal to your stress by strain. Stress is force by area divided by strain is delta L by L, delta L by L, or your y will be equal to your F by A multiplied by L by delta L. F by A multiplied by L by delta L. Children, here A is nothing but area of cross section of the corresponding wire. Area of cross section of the wire is nothing but a circle. Therefore, area will be given by pi r square. Area will be given by pi r square. Therefore, children, your y is equal to F by pi r square. Y will be equal to F divided by pi r square multiplied by L by delta L. Y will be equal to F divided by pi r square multiplied by your L by delta. What are all the constants, children, here? Constants are your y is a constant, F is a constant, pi is a constant. All the three are constants. So, I am going to group everything into one side. Therefore, y into pi by F will be equal to y into pi by f will be equal to L divided by your r square delta L. L divided by r square delta L. Therefore, that is equal to constant, children. Constant will be equal to L divided by r square delta L. Or delta L. Delta L will be equal to 1 by C multiplied by L by r square. Delta L will be equal to 1 by C. That is 1 by C is again a constant. Or delta L is proportional to L by r square. Delta L is proportional to L by r square. That is the change in length is proportional to your length divided by r square. Length divided by r square. Children, in the first case, we can keep, in the first case, we can keep your delta L as delta L and L as L and r as r r. Whereas in the second case, we can have delta L as delta L1. Delta L1 and the length as L1 and r is r1. Okay. And that is about the second case. And therefore, now it has been given that r is doubled. Therefore, what does it imply? R1 will be equal to 2r and L1 will be equal to what? 2L. L1 will be equal to 2L. And R1 will be equal to 2R. Therefore, I am going to divide the ratio, children. I am going to divide your 2 by 1. 2 by 1 implies your delta L1 divided by delta L will be equal to delta L1 by delta L will be equal to L1 by R1 square. The whole thing divided by L by R square. Or this get inverted, children. Therefore, L1 by R1 square multiplied by R square by L. Multiplied by R square by L. And therefore, delta L1 divided by delta L will be equal to L1 is nothing but 2L. R1 is 2R. Therefore, it's 2R the whole square is 4R square. And the right hand side become 2L multiplied by R square divided by 4R square multiplied by L. 2L multiplied by R square divided by 4R square multiplied by L. LL gets cancelled, children. R square gets cancelled. And 2 and 4 gets cancelled. The ratio become 1 by 2. The ratio become 1 by 2. Therefore, delta L1 by delta L will be equal to 1 by 2. Or delta L1 will be equal to half of delta L. Half of delta L. What is delta L, children? It is 1. Delta L is 1. 1 millimeter. Delta L is 1 millimeter. Therefore, if this is 1 millimeter, 1 millimeter is directly 0.5 millimeter. Therefore, your delta L will be equal to half into 1, which is equal to 0.5 millimeter. We need not substitute all the values. We need not substitute all the values and then find, children, the relationship is very important. This relationship is very important. The relationship what we have found in terms of your elongation and length and r square. R, that is very, very important. Please try to understand from the given problem. Same material. It means what? Y is same. So nothing is given, then the same load. If the load is not, load is changing, then F also will be variable. If the load is changing, F also will be variable. Y and pi, for the same material, Y and pi will be constant. Your F will be variable, and therefore F will come again to what? In the numerator. In the, suppose if F is varying, then 1 by C into L into F by r square will come. And again, delta L will depend upon F. But in this case, F is constant because nothing is given. Only one load is given. When I say one load, in both the cases, the same load acts. When the same load acts, then F is constant, Y is constant, pi is already constant. We have the establishment of relationship as your delta L is proportional to F square. So then such relationship is establishment is very, very important. And then it's the correct option for the question number 2 is option D. Option D, 0.5 millimeter. Option D, 0.5 millimeter. Is the correct option for the question number 2. Question number 3. The volume of water changes from 100 liter to 99.5 liters under a pressure of 100 atmosphere. Children, you see, our room pressure is 1 atmospheric pressure. Our room pressure is 1 atmospheric pressure. The volume changes from 100 liters to 99.5 liters to reduce only 0.5 liter. To reduce only 0.5 liter, 500 ml. 500 ml of volume reduction in liquid, it needs a pressure change of your 100 units. You see, 1 atmosphere to 100 atmosphere. Therefore, 100 times increase in pressure is required to change the volume of liquid, to change the volume of liquid by a very, very small value, that is 0.5 liter. Children, please understand that while liquids are compressible, but solids are not compressible, and your gases are highly compressible. That property can be understood by this statement, children. The volume of water changes from 100 liter to 99.5 liter under a pressure of, volume changes from 100 liter to 99.5 liters, and the pressure is how much? They have given your 100 atmosphere, okay, right. The bulk modulus of velocity of water, they are asking your bulk modulus K. Children, bulk modulus K will be equal to minus P divided by delta V by V. That is your P is nothing but pressure. That is called bulk stress divided by bulk strain. Your Young's modulus is linear stress by linear strain. That is your stress by strain normal. Bulk modulus is bulk stress by bulk strain. Bulk stress is nothing but pressure here. For liquids, we call as pressure. And therefore, pressure for liquids and gases, we can call as pressure. Pressure divided by change in volume by original volume. Change in volume by original volume is called as volume strain. It is called as volume strain. Now, therefore, K will be equal to minus P multiplied by V divided by delta V. What is V, children? The initial volume 100 liter is V. What is delta V, children? Delta V is change in volume. Your 99.5 minus 100, that is equal to minus 0.5 liters. That is equal to minus 0.5 liters, okay? Because we are compressing, the volume decrease. Therefore, K will be equal to, what is pressure, children? Pressure they have given as your 100 atmosphere. What is 1 atmosphere, children? 1 atmosphere is 1.0132 bar. 1 atmosphere is 1.0132 bar, or 1 bar will be equal to 10 power 5 Pascal. 10 power 5 Pascal, that is Newton per meter square. 1 Pascal will be equal to 1 Pascal is 1 Newton per meter square, children. Therefore, I can write 1 atmosphere in terms of SI unit will be 1.0132 multiplied by 10 power 5 Newton per meter square. Okay. Directly, I'm going to use the value of pressure as 100 into this value, children. Therefore, K will be equal to minus 100, maybe for want of space, I'll write K here, children. K will be equal to minus 100 multiplied by 1.0132 multiplied by 10 power 5, that is for pressure, multiplied by volume. Volume is how much? Volume is 100 liter. Now, should we change the volume liter in terms of centimeter cube and then meter cube? Not necessary. Why? Because your V divided by delta V, this is also in volume liter. That is also in volume liter. Liter will get cancelled. Don't worry about it. 100 divided by 0.5, 100 divided by minus 0.5. This minus minus gets cancelled. Therefore, K will be equal to 100 multiplied by 100 multiplied by 1.0132 multiplied by your 10 power 5. The whole thing divided by 0.5. 0.5 is nothing but 1 by 2. Therefore, it becomes your 2 times of this value, 2.0264 multiplied by 10 power 5. It is 10 power 4. Therefore, it becomes 10 power 9. What is the unit of K? K unit is unit of pressure. That is Newton per meter square. This will not have any unit. Change in volume by original volume will not have any unit, children. Therefore, it is nothing but directly Newton per meter square. Directly Newton per meter square. Therefore, the correct answer is 2.0264 multiplied by 10 power 9 Newton per meter square. And then the correct option, they have given 2.026 multiplied by 10 power 9. And the correct option is question number for 3. The correct option is option D. Option D is correct option for the question number 3. Question number 4. A copper wire of Y, that is Young's modulus, 1 multiplied by 10 power 11 Newton per meter square. Y of copper, 1 multiplied by 10 power 11 Newton per meter square. Okay. Of length 6 meter. Length of copper 6 meter they have given. And a steel wire, Y of steel. Maybe I can write here, children, Y of steel. It is 2 multiplied by 10 power 11. 2 multiplied by 10 power 11 Newton per meter square. Okay. Right. Of length 4 meter. Length of steel will be equal to 4 meter. Length of steel is 4 meter. Each of cross section 10 power minus 5 meter square. Area of cross section for both 10 power minus 5 meter square. Again, area of cross section is 10 power minus 5 meter square. Area of cross section is constant, children. Please make a note. Okay. Are fastened end to end and stretched by a tension of Newton. Tension force. Again, force. Here also 100 Newton. Now they are fastened end to end. What does it imply? It implies that your copper. Copper is fastened with, this is copper. It is fastened with corresponding steel. This is steel, okay? And it is end to end. Whether you apply a force here, F, the same force is for both copper as well as steel, or whether you apply the force there, whether you, this is copper, this is steel, whether you apply a force there, the same force will be for what? The same force will be for both the your copper and steel. Whether you apply the force in either direction, force will be the same for both the corresponding copper and steel, children. Force will not change, okay? Right. Now, what about the other data given, children? You are fastened end to end and stretched by a tension of 100 Newton. The elongation in the produced in the copper wire. We want delta L of copper. We want delta L of copper. We want delta L of copper. Now, children, we have to understand one thing here. In this case, they are arranged in series. Two metal plates, two metal wires, when they are arranged like this, they are in series. In series, your force will be the same. In series, the force will be the same. In series, the force will be the same. Delta L depends upon Y. Delta L depends upon Y. That is your Young's modulus. That is your Young's modulus of the corresponding substance, children. Because they have got same, your length is different. It also depends upon length. And it has got corresponding your force. Force is same. And not only force, children, your area of cross-section is same for both. Area of cross-section is same for both. And therefore, delta L depends upon basically your Y. Delta L also depends upon what? L in this case, okay? Now, this is with respect to series. But in series, generally, force is same. Now, if they are connected parallelly like this, they are connected to a support. This is your copper. One is copper, the other one is steel. They are connected to a support. And then now, they are made to have a common weight. They are made to have a common mass. Common mass. Okay, now, children, now, this is called a parallel situation. This is called parallel situation. In parallel situation, always elongation is same. In parallel situation, always elongation is constant. Please make a note. In parallel situation, elongation is constant. In series situation, your corresponding, your force is constant. Now, we want only the delta L of copper, children. Now, Y will be equal to, Y will be equal to your stress. That is your F by A divided by delta L by L. Or I can say that is equal to F by A multiplied by your L by delta L. L by delta L. Therefore, Y will be equal to F by A multiplied by L by delta L. We want the value of delta L. Therefore, delta L will be equal to your F by A multiplied by L by Y. F by A multiplied by L by Y. Now, for copper, everything is for copper, children. Delta L of copper will be equal to F of copper. Copper, both force is same. A of copper, both area is same. L of copper, we know the value. Y of copper, we know the value. Therefore, children, your delta L of copper will be equal to F and A are same, and L of copper divided by Y of copper. Similarly, for steel, you should have F and A will be the same. For L of steel divided by your Young's modulus, that is Y of steel will come. Now, therefore, delta L of copper will be equal to, what is the value of F, children? We have got the corresponding value of F as your 100 Newton. Everything is in SI unit. 100 divided by area. Area is 10 power minus 5. 10 power minus 5 multiplied by, what is your L of U? It is 6 meter. 6 divided by, that again is in SI unit, children. 6 meter divided by, what is your Young's modulus? 1 multiplied by 10 power 11 Newton per meter square. 1 multiplied by 10 power 11 Newton per meter square. That is equal to, you can have, children, 10 power 11, 10 power minus 5, 10 power plus 6. That becomes 10 power plus 6, okay? And then 6 will be there in the numerator and 10 power 2 will be there. And 10 power plus 6, when it's got numerator, it becomes 10 power minus 6. 10 power 2 is there. 2 minus 6 is minus 4. Therefore, your 6 multiplied by 10 power minus 4, your meter. 6 multiplied by 10 power minus 4 meter. And then the correct option will be, they are given in terms of millimeter, children. 6 multiplied by 10 power minus 1 multiplied by 10 power minus 3 meter. 10 power minus 3 meter is millimeter, and 6 by 10, this is 1 by 10, 6 by 10 is 0.6 millimeter. Therefore, delta L of copper will be 0.6 millimeter. Similarly, you can calculate the corresponding delta L of your steel. If at all they are, you can calculate the delta L of steel. But, children, please be rest assured, in this situation, you are in this situation, delta L will change. Only force remains constant. In serious situation, force remains constant. In parallel situation, your delta L remains constant, force varies. Please make a note, that is very, very important. Also, one more concept here. The total extension will be equal to sum of the extension of copper plus sum of the extension of copper and corresponding steel, children. That is very, very important. When they ask the total extension, then it will be what? The corresponding delta L Cu plus delta L of steel. Now, I will give you one more concept which is not there now in this question. What is the concept? Suppose, if they are asking the effective Young's modulus of the combination. Okay. Now, obviously, both have similar cross-sectional area. The net cross-section area is also A. And both have same force, net force is also A. Therefore, delta L total, how to find? Children, now, your Y will be equal to F by A multiplied by F by A multiplied by L by delta L. Okay, L by delta L. Your Y of total will be equal to your net effect combination will be equal to F divided by A because F does not change and area also is constant here. Okay, multiplied by L of total, net effect L total divided by the total length divided by the corresponding total extension. Total extension. What is the total extension, children? Therefore, total extension will be equal to your total F by A multiplied by F by A multiplied by length total divided by your Y total. Now, this value will be equal to, this is your, this, children, and hence, therefore, your F by A multiplied by L total divided by your Y total will be equal to, Y is nothing but the Young's modulus of effective combination will be equal to, similarly, for delta LCU, F by A multiplied by LCU divided by your Y of Cu plus F by A multiplied by L of steel divided by Y of corresponding steel. Now, F by A is constant for all the cases. Therefore, I can rule out F by A. Your L total by Y total will be equal to LCU by YCU plus corresponding L steel, length of steel divided by Y of steel. Therefore, children, such formula, Don't try to remember this formula because they may give not your same length. They may give different area of cross section also. So therefore, A also here need not be the same. It can change. When area changes, F will be the same. F gets cancelled. Therefore, here when area changes, 1 by A total will be equal to your this again multiplied by 1 by A copper. This again multiplied by 1 by area of corresponding steel. Such form, please don't by heart understand the concept. And hence, the correct option for the question number 4, is option C, 0.6 millimeter. Is the correct option for the question number 4. Question number 5. A body of mass 1 kg is fastened to end-to-end of a steel. A body of mass 1 kg, we have a separate body, maybe a circular object or a rectangular object or maybe a cubical object, whatever may be. The mass is your 1 kg. It is fastened to one end of a steel wire. It is attached to one end of a steel wire of area of cross-section, your 3 multiplied by 10 power minus 6 meter square. Okay, and is rotated in a horizontal circle. We are rotating the wire like this. That is called horizontal circle. When we rotate with respect to horizontal circle, children, obviously there is a force acting towards the center. That force is called as what? Your centripetal force. Centripetal force is responsible for the force acting towards the center, and that force again is responsible for the extension of the wire. Because that same force is called a centrifugal also. It is a pseudo force, and centrifugal force is not acting actually, only when rotation it comes into picture. And therefore, that force is responsible for any extension of the corresponding wire, children. Now, in the question number 5, we have the corresponding diagram, children. I have a mass of your mass 1 kg. Mass 1 kg is fastened to an end of a steel wire. I have a corresponding steel wire. Here I hold. And here the mass 1 kg is kept. Okay, 1 kg is kept. It is now horizontally, it is made to rotate. Now, that is your corresponding horizontal circle, children. When I say the horizontal circle is formed like this, it gets like this. This length becomes the radius of the circle. Okay, right. A body of mass 1 kg is fastened to one end of a steel wire of area of cross-section. Your area of cross-section is being given as 3 multiplied by 10 power minus 6 meter square. Okay, right. What about the and is rotated horizontal circle of radius 20 centimeter. This is nothing but 20 centimeter, children. That is nothing but length of the wire. Length of the wire is what? 20 centimeter. That is the radius of the horizontal circle what we are rotating. Okay. Now, you are with the speed of your 2 meter per second. Therefore, the horizontal velocity velocity component which is tangential to the circle is nothing but V is equal to 2 meter. I have given the velocity as 2 meter per second. Then the elongation in the wire delta L will be equal to dash question mark, provided we have the value Y as 2 multiplied by 10 power 11 Newton per meter square. 2 multiplied by 10 power 11 Newton per meter square. Now how to proceed, children. We know the value Y will be equal to F by A multiplied by L by delta L. We know the value F by A, Y will be equal to F by A multiplied by L by delta. Therefore, what is delta L? Delta L will be equal to F by A multiplied by L by Y. In this, what is your A, children? We know the value. A, we know the value. What about L, children? L, we know the value, 20 centimeter. What about your Y, children? Y, we know the value. It is being given in the problem. And we need to find the value of F. F is nothing but the force pulling the wire. F is nothing but the force pulling the wire. The force pulling the wire is equal to your centrifugal force. And that is nothing but mv square by r. That is nothing but mv square by r. Therefore, here the force will be equal to mv square by r. Here the force will be equal to mv square by r, children. Now I am going to substitute the value here. Mv square by r multiplied by your 1 by a multiplied by l by y. But l and r are both are same. L and r are both are same, children. The radius of the circle will be equal to length of the wire. And therefore, I can cancel this R and L. It is mv square divided by ay. Therefore, delta L will be equal to mv square by a multiplied by y. What is mass, children? Mass is 1 kg. Multiplied by what is v, children? It is 2. 2 square divided by what is a, children? It is 3 multiplied by 10 power minus 6. What is y, children? It is 2 multiplied by 10 power 11. Everything is in terms of SI unit. And fortunately or unfortunately, this is in terms of centimeter. But that gets cancelled. L by R gets cancelled. And obviously, we need not worry about the corresponding variable, children. Now, what about the value? Delta L will be equal to, I can cancel the 2. Therefore, it is 2 by 3. 2 by 3 multiplied by, this is nothing but 10 power 5. 10 power 5. 11 minus 6 is 5. Therefore, that becomes 10 power minus 5. That is equal to 2 by 3 is 0.666 multiplied by 10 power minus 5. Therefore, 2.666 multiplied by 10 power minus 5. So much of meter. Now they have given in terms of your what about the value, children? Let us see. Now we have the corresponding. Have we missed any term, any terminology? Okay, no, it's a fifth question. I am just seeing the fourth question answer. Sorry, extremely sorry. 0.67 multiplied by 10 power minus 5. That is given. That is there. It's approximately 0.67 multiplied by 10 power minus 5 meter, children. And therefore, the correct option. For the question number 5 is option B. Option B is correct option for the question number 5, which is delta L will be equal to 0.67 multiplied by 10 power minus 5 meter. Okay, right. What about question number 6? The approximate depth of a ocean, the depth of the ocean is nothing but the corresponding height from the ground level, from the bottom of the ocean. So the approximate height of the approximate depth of the ocean is 2700 meter. It is a very, very huge value, children. It is 2700 meter depth. The compressibility of water is being given as your 45.5 10 power minus Pascal. Children, if you don't know what compressibility, please try to understand in terms of unit. It is a reciprocal of what pressure? You can see there is a reciprocal of pressure. The reciprocal of pressure is called as what? Your compressibility. And the compressibility of water is being given as 45.4 multiplied by 10 power minus 1 Pascal per minus 1. Okay. And the density is being given as 10 power 3 kg per meter cube. Density is being given as 10 power 3 kg per meter cube. Okay. That's okay. What about the corresponding fractional detail required is fractional compression of water. Children, in question number 6, you are being given with the depth is 2700 meter. And what about the compressibility factor? Compressibility factor will be equal to your compressibility factor 45.4 multiplied by 45.4 multiplied by 10 power minus 11. That is Pascal power minus 1, Pascal inverse. They have given the density of water. Density of water is your 10 power 3 kg per meter cube. 10 power 3 kg per meter cube, or is nothing but 1 gram per centimeter cube. It is also equal to 1 gram per centimeter cube or 1 gram per ml. Both are same. Okay, now they are asking fractional compression of water will be obtained at the bottom of the ocean. At the bottom of the ocean, what is the fractional compression? At the bottom of the ocean, the fractional compression will be equal to the fractional compression will be equal to compressibility factor. Compressibility factor multiplied by pressure at the bottom, multiplied by pressure at the bottom. What is the pressure at the bottom, children? We know the formula. Your pressure will be equal to rho g h. Pressure will be, that is h rho g r. Instead of h, I have the depth, children. Therefore, density is 10 power 3 multiplied by gravity is 10, assuming, okay, 10 meter per second square, which is what? That is the thing by depth. That is 2700. Therefore, which is, I can say, 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 2, 6. 27 multiplied by 10 power 6. 27 multiplied by 10 power 6. And that should be your corresponding Pascal, children. That should be corresponding Pascal. What is fractional compression? This is in terms of inverse Pascal. Inverse Pascal into Pascal will give you the corresponding compression. And it has got no unit. It has got no unit. Therefore, fractional compression will be equal to, what is the compressibility factor? 45.4 multiplied by 10 power minus 11 multiplied by your 27 multiplied by corresponding 10 power 6, minus 11, this minus 11, okay, right. Now, therefore, 45.4 multiplied by 27 multiplied by 10 power minus 5. 45.4 multiplied by 27 multiplied by 10 power minus 5. Now, children, when you multiply your 45.4 and then 27, the value here, it comes, they have given as 1.2 multiplied by 10 power minus 2. Let us try to understand the value in terms of the nearest quantity, children. Now, 45, maybe all the other powers, every power is 10 power minus 2. So, all powers are 10 power minus 2. There is no other go. You have to multiply and check, children. 27 multiplied by 45.4. Please do multiply, do the calculation on your own. And that will come to around. Maybe if they have given that 1.2, if they have given 1.2 multiplied by 10 power minus 2 as the answer, if they have given 1.2 multiplied by 10 power minus 2 as the answer, the minus 3, that is divided by 1000, then this will become approximately 12,000. 45 multiplied by 2 will be 900. It should be around 1200, children. That should be around 1200. 1200 divided by your multiply by that this approximate value should be around 1200. 1200 multiplied by 10 power minus 5. I divide by 1000 here, and therefore it will get 1.2 multiplied by 10 power minus 2. So therefore, please check, children, check for the validity of this particular number, and the correct option given is option C, 1.2 multiplied by 10 power minus 2. The correct option given in the textbook is option C, 1.2 multiplied by 10 power minus 2. Please check the correctness of the answer, children. Question number 7. Because it's a simple multiplication, I did not do. Question number 7. A copper rod of length L and radius R is suspended in the ceiling by one of its ends. We have a ceiling. A copper rod of uniform cross-section, it should be straight, okay? Of length L, and the area of cross-section will be here. The area of cross-section of radius R, okay? Now, a copper rod of length L and radius R is suspended from the ceiling by one of its ends. Okay, it is suspended. And the ceiling is one end fixed, the other end is suspended. Just like that left. What will be the elongation of the rod due to its own weight? Children, the weight will be equal due to its own weight. Please understand the word own weight. The word own weight is very, very important. What do you mean by own weight? We'll just discuss. Weight, the equal to weight is nothing but mg, the force acting. Therefore, that is nothing but a force that we have to understand. Now, therefore, own weight is this, where rho and y are the density and Young's modulus of copper. Your rho is the density of copper, and y is the Young's modulus of copper. Young's modulus of corresponding copper. Now, we need to find the value of the corresponding extension. What will be the elongation of the copper? We want to find the value of elongation, children. How to go about, children? Now, we know the value. Your y will be equal to f by a multiplied by your corresponding l by delta l. Therefore, delta l will be equal to f by a multiplied by l by your corresponding l by y. Now, children, this is a formula, but how to go about understanding the formula with respect to the word own weight? Now, when I say own weight, the weight of the object exactly acts at the center of gravity. That is at the midpoint. Midpoint, because the object is symmetric. Exactly the weight of the object acts only here. W acts only here. Therefore, W acts only here, that is your mg, which is nothing but a force. And that force is acting at a distance of only L by 2, only L by 2, not L, not L. This force is responsible. This force is responsible for the stretching of only this segment, and the bottom segment will not be stretched. The bottom segment will not be stretched. The bottom segment will not be stretched. Why the bottom segment will not be stretched? Because the bottom segment, the force does not act. Only the force acts at the center of gravity. The force acts at the center of gravity or the center of mass. Center of mass here for a symmetric object will be at the center, exactly at the center. And therefore, the whole length is L and the center will be L by 2 from the ceiling. The center will be L by 2 from the ceiling. Therefore, in this L should be replaced by L by 2. Why L should be replaced by L by 2? Because the force is acting, the weight is acting. When I replace F by W, then definitely I have to change L to L by 2. Now, what does this imply? Suppose if I am going to have the same length L, I am going to apply a force F here. Now the force is acting for the entire length. Here, your delta L will be equal to F by A multiplied by your L by Y. Now L is correct. Whereas in the previous case, your delta L will be equal to, when I replace W, that is nothing but weight of the object, W by A multiplied by, here L will not be there, L by 2 divided by Y. Therefore, your delta L will be equal to your mg, that is nothing but weight, is nothing but mg by A multiplied by L by 2y, mg by A multiplied by L by 2y. They have given density and your Young's modulus. Density will be equal to your mass into mass. Density will be equal to mass by volume. Therefore, what is mass? Density into volume. What is your volume? Volume will be area multiplied by corresponding length. Area multiplied by corresponding length. I am going to use this, children. When I am going to use that equation there, therefore, delta L will be equal to mass is density into volume. Density into volume multiplied by G divided by A multiplied by L divided by 2Y. What is volume, children? Volume. You should not consider A into L by 2. Please don't do that. Volume is for the entire material, because density is for entire thing. And the entire mass is there. Only half the segment is extended. That is very, very important. And therefore, delta L will be equal to, I'm going to use V equal to AL, rho into A into L into G multiplied by L divided by A multiplied by 2Y. I can cancel A and A. Rho g L square by 2y. Therefore, your delta L will be equal to rho g corresponding L square divided by 2y. Rho g L square by 2y. And hence, the corresponding option, rho g L square by 2y, is the second option for the question number 7. And hence, the correct option for the question number 7 is option B. Option B is the correct option for the question number 7. Question number 8. The following four wires are made of the same material. The following four wires are made of the same material. Which of these have the largest extension when the same tension is applied? Children, what tension, children? Force. Here, they have given same material. They have also given same tension. That is force. So, material is same. Tension is same. They have given four options varying with what? Your length and diameter. Now, therefore, we are going to find the corresponding relationship between your elongation. They have maximum extension. Elongation and your length and diameter. Now, children, for the question number your 8, your y will be equal to, again, F by A multiplied by L by delta L, or delta L will be equal to F by A multiplied by L by Y. Here, your F is constant, Y is constant, same load. It means F remains constant. Your same material, it means your Y is constant. Therefore, F by Y is constant. I am going to group. What is area, children? Area is pi r square, children. Pi r square, we know that r will be equal to diameter d by 2. And therefore, it is nothing but pi into d by 2 the whole square, which is nothing but pi d square by 4. Therefore, your delta L will be equal to your F divided by pi d square by 4 multiplied by L by Y. Okay, right. Now, I am going to have the reorientation of the corresponding expression 4 goes to numerator. If I am going to rearrange the constant children, 4 is a constant, F is a constant, Y is a constant, Pi is a constant. Everything is constant. And L, D square are the variable. L, D square are the variable children. Therefore, delta L is proportional to. Therefore, delta L is proportional to L by D square. Delta L is proportional to L by D square. Now, for the case 1, delta L1 will be equal to. And 1 is in centimeter, 1 is in millimeter. Better convert everything in terms of what? Your meter, children. Therefore, for the first one, delta L1 will be equal to. What is L, children? 50 centimeter. 50 multiplied by 10 power minus 2 divided by. Everything is in terms of millimeter, children. 0.5 millimeter. 0.5 the whole square. 0.5 multiplied by 10 power minus 3 the whole square. And therefore, this is nothing but 0.25. 0.5 into 0.5. 50 multiplied by 10 power minus 2 divided by 0.25 multiplied by 10 power minus 6. I'm not going to do the calculation, children. I'm going to compare the values. And therefore, just don't calculate. Just find the next value. Your next is 100 centimeter. Therefore, 100 multiplied by 10 power minus 2. 100 multiplied by 10 power minus 2 divided by. What about the 1 millimeter? 1 is nothing but 1 multiplied by 10 power minus 6. 1 multiplied by 10 power minus 6. You can see, children, your 10 power minus 2 and 10 power minus 6 terms are common for all the terms. For all the both delta N1 and delta L2. Similarly, for other three also, the term will be constant. And therefore, we can compare only with the first, 50 by 0.25. 100 by 50 by 0.25 is 1 by 4. 1 by 4 is 200. Therefore, 50 into 4 is 200 by 1, 200. This is nothing but 100. Obviously, 200 is more than 100. What about the next one? You got 200 centimeter. 200 multiplied by 10 power minus 2 divided by the corresponding 2 millimeter. 2 square is 4. 4 multiplied by 10 power minus 6. Again, these two are constant, children. 200 by 4 is 50. 200 by 4 is 50. Your 200, 150. What about delta L4? Delta L4. Again, it is nothing but 300 centimeter. 300 multiplied by 10 power minus 2. What about the radius, children? Diameter? It is 3 millimeter. 3 square is 9. 9 multiplied by 10 power minus 6. Same 10 power, children. So 300 by 9. 300 by 9 will be approximately 3 point something. This is 3 point something. This is 5. 50. This is 30 point something. Okay, this is 30 point something. This is 50. This is 100. This is 200. Obviously, your delta L1 is much higher. Delta L1 is much higher. And therefore, the correct option for the question number 8 is length 50 centimeter and diameter 0.5 millimeter. See, children, it's a neat 2015 question. Again, your compressibility factor 6 is a 2015 question. Please make a note of these things, children. Such questions are very, very important. Question number 8, the correct option is option A. Question number 8, the correct option is option A. And that's about your question number 8, children. Question number 9. We can go with the next question, children. Question number 9. Question number 9, the breaking stress for a copper wire, that is stress for a copper wire. That is called breaking. When I say breaking stress, then at that particular stress, the corresponding wire will break down. At that particular stress, the corresponding wire will break down, or the length of the wire will get broken down. Okay, that is the idea. The breaking stress for a copper wire is 2.2 multiplied by 10 power 8 newton per meter square. The breaking stress is being given as your 2.2 multiplied by 10 power 8 newton per meter square. The maximum length of the copper wire with which it can be suspended vertically, for which the wire will not break. The wire will not break under its own weight. Under its own weight, it should not break. Okay, right. Therefore, question number 9, your breaking stress is being given as your value 2.2. 2.2 multiplied by 10 power 8 newton per meter square. 10 power 8 newton per meter square. Now, what about the next value, children? They have asked the maximum length. They have asked for the maximum length so that the copper wire can withstand. The maximum length L max will be equal to dash, okay? And its own weight, it will not break because of its own weight. That is very, very important. It will not break because of its own weight. That word is very, very important, children. But for calculation of your Young's modulus, we need to calculate the length as L by 2 because the weight will be acting at the center. Now, in this case, breaking stress, they are asking. Let us analyze the question, children. Now, therefore, will not break under its own weight. Will be the density of copper is being given as density rho will be equal to your 8.8 multiplied by 10 power 3 kg per meter cube. Kg per meter cube. Children, what is your breaking stress? Breaking stress will be equal to your force by corresponding area. Force by area. Okay, what is force, children? The breaking stress value they have given directly. Now, walking, what is force? Force is nothing but own weight. Own weight is nothing but mg. One weight will be equal to what? Corresponding mg, children. Therefore, your breaking stress 2.2 multiplied by 10 power 8 will be equal to but mg by a. mg by a. And what is m, children? Here, mass. Mass will be equal to density into volume. Mass will be equal to density into volume. 2.2 multiplied by 10 power 8 will be equal to density into volume into gravity divided by a. Again, what is volume, children? Area multiplied by length. And that length is nothing but breaking length. That length is maximum length. And therefore, your rho into a into l, your g divided by a gets cancelled. If the breaking stress is maximum, then the length is also extended, is also maximum. That is, up to maximum length, it can withstand. Therefore, 2.2 multiplied by 10 power 8 will be equal to rho lg. Therefore, your L will be equal to 2.2 multiplied by 10 power 8 divided by rho g. That is 2.2 multiplied by 10 power 8. What is rho, children? It is 8.8. 8.8 multiplied by 10 power 3. And g is again 10. I hope my calculations are correct. This becomes 1 by 4. Multiplied by, this is nothing but 10 power 4. So 10 power 8 minus 4, 10 power 4. And this becomes 0.25. 0.25 multiplied by 10 power 4, which is nothing but 25 multiplied by 10 square, your meter. 25 multiplied by 10 square meter. Children, let us try to understand the corresponding value. Yeah, it has been given as 2500 meter. Correct. 2500 meter or 25 multiplied by 10 power 2 meter. And then the correct option for the question number 9 is option. Option B is the correct option for question number 9. Question number 10. A load of 25 kg weight is applied on a wire of diameter 0.4 cm due to which its length increases from 100 cm to 102 cm. Then the Young's modulus of the wire is being given as. Children, now in the question number 10, a load of your value 25 kg weight. When I say kg weight, it is in terms of the corresponding CGS unit, children. Now, 1 kg weight will be equal to, or 1 gram weight will be equal to 980 corresponding dyne, children. Now, in this case, they have given two options in terms of dyne and two options in terms of your Newton per meter square. Now, 1 Newton will be equal to 10 power 5 dynes. 1 Newton will be equal to 10 power 5 dynes. So, now, I am going to convert this, your load as 25 multiplied by 10 power 3 gram weight, that is multiplied by your 980. In terms of your CGS unit, that is in terms of dyne will come. Okay. The force will be expressed in terms of what? Your dyne. So 25 multiplied by 1000 multiplied by 980. The 1 gram weight will be equal to 980 dynes. 1 gram weight. As we know that your corresponding 1 kg weight, we can understand as 9.8 meter per second square, children. 9.8 Newton. 1 kg weight is 9.8 Newton. In terms of SI unit, in terms of CGS unit, it is 980 dynes. Now, therefore, F is equal to 25 multiplied by 10 power 3 multiplied by 980 dynes. What about the value? The diameter value they have given. Diameter, they have value given as 0.4 centimeter. Or I can find the radius as what? 0.2 centimeter. Both are correct. You can even use diameter and then use the formula pi d square before. That's also correct. Or you can convert in them in terms of centimeter. Please have it in centimeter because we are doing in CGS unit. We are not doing. If at all you are converting everything in terms of SI unit, then you have to convert 25 kg weight in terms of what? 25 into 9.8 Newton. This will be 25 into 9.8 Newton. Okay. And then this will be 0.2 multiplied by 10 power minus 2 meter. Those conversions I am going to do in terms of only CGS unit, children. Now, you are increases the length from 100 centimeter to 102 centimeter. Therefore, change in length is 102 centimeter minus 100 centimeter, which is again your 2 centimeter. Again, your delta L will be in terms of what? Your centimeter, children. Now, radius is in terms of centimeter, length is also in terms of centimeter, right? What about your Young's modulus? Now, children, the original length is what? The initial length is 100. The initial length should be 100 centimeter because that is the value from 100 to 200 is increasing. Therefore, initial value is L. Now, what is the Young's modulus, children? Young's modulus will be equal to, F will be equal to, Y will be equal to F by A multiplied by L by delta L. F by A multiplied by L by delta L. Now, they are asking the value of corresponding Young's modulus, children. What is F? F will be equal to 25 multiplied by, I can make this as 98 multiplied by 10 power 4. 98 multiplied by 10 power 4. Okay, 98 multiplied by 10 power 4 divided by area. Area is pi r, pi into pi multiplied by r square is 0.2. 0.2 square directly we can have in terms of centimeter itself because everything is centimeter. Multiplied by length, it is 100 centimeter divided by the corresponding your change in length, 2 centimeter, 2. Okay. Now, the value will be in terms of dynes per, the value will be in terms of dynes per centimeter square because we are calculating in terms of CGS unit. Now, Y will be equal to your 25. I am going to remove all the 10 power, children. 25 multiplied by 98 multiplied, this becomes 10 power 6. 10 power 6, the whole thing divided by, the whole thing divided by 2 multiplied by, this becomes, you are 2 multiplied by point 10 power minus 1. This becomes 2 multiplied by 10 power minus 1. And that will be 4 multiplied by 10 power minus 2. Therefore, your 3.14 is for y multiplied by 2 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 10 power minus your 2. Okay, I hope my calculations go with correctly. Now, you are every power is they have given in terms of 10 power 9, 10 power 9, 10 power 9, 10 power 9. And therefore, nearest to 10 power 9, we will try to operate children. Therefore, now that is equal to 25 multiplied by 98, 25 multiplied by 98 divided by 3.14 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 10 power 8. That becomes 10 power 8. Now I am going to make this as 10 power 9. Okay, when I am going to make, because numerator is numerator is huge value. It's a huge value. Denominator is 3 approximately 3. 3 multiplied by 2 is 6. 6 multiplied by 4 is 24. Denominator is approximately 24 children. Therefore, 25 and 24 I can cancel. 25 and 24 I can cancel. When I cancel 25 and 24, it will be 9.8, 98 multiplied by 10 power 9. 98 multiplied by 10 power 9 or, yeah, that is, you can see the option. When I cancel this value, 3.4 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 4, that becomes 4 2s are 8, 8 3s are 24. 24, again, we have 0.14. Therefore, nearest value will be 25. I can cancel this and say this approximately equal 1 and 1, okay? Therefore, your nearest value of the Young's modulus will be 98 multiplied by 10 power 9, so much of dynes per centimeter square. Now that's the ring, but 98 multiplied by 10 power 8, okay, 98 multiplied by 10 power 8. And that is the ring, but 9.8 multiplied by 10 power 9, so much of dynes per centimeter square. Therefore, children, having approximated this value, the correct option will be for the question number 10, the correct option is, you can see, 9.75 multiplied by 10 power 9 Newton per meter square is second option, ruled out. And third option in terms of numbers ruled out, 5.79, 5.79. And third and fourth. And 9.75 multiplied by 10 power 9, that is the nearest answer. And then the correct option for the question number 10 is option A, 9.75 multiplied by 10 power 9 dyne per centimeter square. Children, question number 11. A 10 meter long thick rubber pipe. A 10 meter long length of the pipe is 10 meter. A 10 meter long thick rubber pipe. We have got area of cross section, considerable area of cross section. And that is they have given as thick rubber pipe. A 10 meter long thick rubber pipe is suspended from one of its ends. Okay. Right. The extension produced in the pipe under its own weight. Children, please underline the word its own weight. Please underline the word its own weight. When I say its own weight, then what should be the length of the pipe should be taken into account in terms of calculating the Young's modulus, because the weight will act at the center of gravity of the pipe. The weight will act at the center of gravity of the pipe or the center of gravity of the rod, and therefore the corresponding length for calculation of Young's modulus should be not your L. It should be taken as L by 2. That should be taken as L by 2. Please register those things, children. That is very, 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 very important. Okay. Now, your question number 11. A 10 meter long thick rubber pipe is suspended from one of its end. Suspended. So, it is suspended like this. Okay. Now, this is totally 10 meter. This is totally 10 meter. But the weight will act only at the center. Weight will act only at the center. And that is the length of the center of gravity from the above will be your 5 meter. From the above will be 5 meter. Okay. The extension produced in the pipe under its own weight. Under its own weight. That word own weight. Please register the word own weight. Please register the word own weight. Okay. And under its own weight will be your the extension they are asking. They are asking about the delta L. Delta L equal to question mark. And they are given the value of Y as 5 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 10 power 5 Newton per meter square. 5 multiplied by 10 power 5 Newton per meter square. And the density of the rubber is 1,500 kg per meter cube. Density they are given as 1,500 kg per meter cube. Children, we want the value of delta L. Okay. Now, how to go about the calculation? Already we know the formula Y will be equal to F by A multiplied by L by delta L. L by delta L. We want delta L. Delta L will be equal to F by A multiplied by L by your corresponding Y. But when you are going to calculate the extension because of own weight, I am going to make this as weight divided by A, and I am going to make this as L by 2 multiplied by 1 by Y multiplied by 1 by what is weight, children? Mass multiplied by gravity divided by A divided by area multiplied by L by 2 multiplied by 1 by Y, and that is your delta L. Now, what is mass, density into volume, children? Therefore, density into volume, your density is mass by volume, mass is density into volume. Density into volume into gravity divided by A multiplied by L by 2 multiplied by 1 by, I can cancel volume as A into L. Therefore, delta L will be equal to rho into A into L into G divided by A multiplied by L by 2 multiplied by 1 by Y. Okay, now I can cancel A and A, I say rho G L square divided by 2Y. Therefore, delta L will be equal to rho G L square divided by 2Y. Rho G L square by 2Y. What is rho, children? Rho will be equal to, your given is 1500. 1500. What is G, children? 10. What is L? L, you can now take 10 meter because I have already divided by 2. Therefore, it is 10 meter. 10 multiplied by 10. 10 square. Divided by 2 multiplied. What is Young's modulus, children? 5 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 10 power 5. 5 multiplied by 10 power 5. Okay. Now, this 10 square, 10 cube. 10 power 5 gets cancelled. This 10 power 3, this 10 square gets cancelled. 15 by 10, which is nothing but 0.5. 15 by 10, which is nothing but 1.5, children. 1500 multiplied by, let us understand the value, children, in terms of correctness. They have given 1.5A as the answer. Have we gone somewhere wrong? Let us try to understand the data. Oh, children, your Y, they have given as, Y, they have given as 10 power 6. I have wrongly written as 10 power 5. Maybe the error with respect to parallax error mistake, children. 5 multiplied by 10 power 6. This value is 5 multiplied by 10 power 6. And therefore, I am going to change here as what? 10 power 6. When I change here as 10 power 6, 10 power 6, 10 power 6 can be understood as 10 power 5 multiplied by 10. And therefore, one more 10 will be in the numerator, denominator. One more 10 will be in the denominator. Therefore, 15 divided by 100. 15 divided by 100, which is equal to what? 0.15 meter. 0.15 meter. Therefore, the option 0.15 meter is the correct option on the, for the question number 11. And then the correct option for the question number 11 is option B. Correct option for the question number 11 is option B. Children, if the value is 5 multiplied by 10 power 5, then definitely it has to be 1.5. Don't worry about the value, children. Please try to understand the method. Please try to understand the method. But definitely, I earnestly request you not to make mistake in taking data from the problem. I earnestly request you all not to make mistake in extracting the data from the problem. The 10 power 5, 10 power 6, all this 5 and 6 will be very, very similar in terms of printing. Really 3 and 8 will be very, very similar. If 3 is not properly printed, then it may look like 8. And I request you to go through the problem carefully and seriously with more sincerity and extract the data correctly. Okay. And that's about question number 11, children. Question number 12. A rigid bar of mass M is supported symmetrically. A rigid bar of mass M is supported symmetrically by 3 wires of length, each of length L. Okay. A rigid bar is supported symmetrically. Is supported symmetrically by 3 wires. Bar is supporting symmetrically 3 wires, or a wire is supporting the bar. I don't know. Let us draw the diagram. A rigid bar of mass M is supported symmetrically by 3 wires, each of length. Okay. Now I have got a ceiling. Now I have 3 wires. Okay. Now I have a mass M. Okay. Now a rigid body of mass M is supported symmetrically by 3 wires, each of length L, and each of length L. Now this is in parallel system, children. In parallel, I have informed that in series force will be same. In series, force will be constant. Whereas in parallel, extension will be constant. Extension will be constant. Okay. That is very, very important. Now, those at each end are copper. And middle is one of iron. Those, a rigid bar of mass M is supported symmetrically by 3 wires. Okay. Those at each end are copper. So, this is copper. This is again copper. Whereas middle is your corresponding iron. Okay. Right. Now, how to go about the understanding of your, the ratio of the diameters if each has to have the same tension. Now they have given, in parallel already delta L is same. In parallel already delta L is same. Now they have given, your force is also constant. That is tension. T is tension. Tension is nothing but force. That is also constant they have given. Now your what is delta L children? Delta L will be, that is yeah, Y. Y will be equal to your F by A. F by A multiplied by L. Now they are asking what the ratio of the diameter of each wire will be in the form of. Obviously the diameters are different children. You can see the independent wires are different. Two wires are copper and the other one is iron. Okay. The other one is iron. Therefore, diameters they have not given. And we can assume the area as what? Pi d square by 4. Area as pi d square by 4. Therefore, equal to your divided by pi d square by 4 multiplied by L by delta L. Now I'm going to rearrange children. Y will be equal to 4f divided by pi d square multiplied by L divided by delta L. What are the constant children? 4 is constant, pi is constant, f is constant, and L is also constant, same length. L is also constant. Delta L is also constant because they are parallel. Delta L is also constant because it's parallel. The parallel delta L is constant. Children, therefore, now everything is constant. Only the variable is what? The variable is y. The variable is d square. Y is proportional to? Y is proportional to 1 by d square. Or d square is proportional to what? 1 by y. Or d is proportional to 1 by root y. Therefore, diameter of copper divided by diameter of corresponding iron, diameter of iron will be equal to your 1 by root of y of copper divided by 1 by root of y of iron. And y of iron will go to the numerator children. Therefore, your diameter of copper divided by diameter of iron will be equal to root of your y of iron divided by root of y of copper. Root of y of, or you can say root of y of iron divided by y of copper. This is your diameter of copper to the diameter of iron will be equal to the ratio, square root of ratio of the Young's modulus of iron with respect to that of corresponding copper. Now they are asking the ratio of their diameters. They are asking with respect to your copper first, and then they have given those at each end is copper and then middle is iron. The end is copper, middle is those. First comes copper and then only iron, children. And therefore, the ratio of the diameter also in the same order, diameter of copper to diameter of iron will be equal to square root of y of iron divided by y of copper. And then the correct option for the question number 12 is option B. Option B is the correct option for the question number 12. Question number 13. The correct graph verifying Hooke's law. Hooke's law says that your stress is directly proportional to strain, or strain is directly proportional to what? Stress. More the stress, more will be the strain, or more the strain, more will be the stress. Therefore, children, your stress by strain remains constant. That is the idea of your Hooke's law, children. Now, they have given different curves. They have given a straight line downward, and then you have got a parabolic curve, cubical curve, parabola curve upward, cubical parabola downward. You have got exponential curve in terms of your normal logarithmic exponent. Okay, right, logarithmic curve. And then C option is a straight line increasing. Now, they have given the diagram with respect to elongation and extension and load. Okay. Now, your question number 13, I'm going to have the Hooke's law. Hooke's law is nothing but your stress by strain. Stress by strain is constant. What is stress, children? Y by A. What is strain, children? Delta L by L. That will be equal to constant. That is called Young's modulus. Therefore, F by A multiplied by L by delta L will be equal to constant. Now, we want the graph on the y-axis. It is extension. On the y-axis, it is extension. That is your delta L. On the x-axis, it is load. Therefore, this becomes the force, becomes the load. That is your x-axis. And this becomes the y-axis. Okay. Now, therefore, I am going to just cross multiply, children. Your F by A, will be equal to into L will be equal to C times of your delta Y. C is m to delta L. Okay. Therefore, what is delta L, children? Delta L will be equal to F by A multiplied by L by C. F by A multiplied by L by C. They want the graph between delta L and F. Therefore, L by AC is a constant. L by A, L is constant, A is constant, C is constant. L by AC, another constant, your K. Therefore, delta L will be equal to K times of F. Delta L will be equal to K times of F. This is your x-axis. That is extension. That is your Y. That is extension is Y. And your load is along the x-axis. In every graph, load is along the x-axis. Load is nothing but force. Therefore, K times of Y is equal to KX. y is equal to kx is of the form y is equal to mx. Y is equal to mx is the straight line. Y is equal to mx is the straight line passing through origin. Y is equal to mx is the straight line passing through origin. Even though you know the direct graph of Hooke's law, don't plot like that. Don't try to understand the graph like that. Even though you know the graph of Hooke's law, don't try to understand like that from the textbook. Please, because the variable will, they would have changed. They would have given here elongation, extension versus load. They have given extension versus load. Now I can give in terms of 1 by extension versus load. I can give in a various form, children. Please try to understand the concept of the problem, the variable, the x-axis parameter, y-axis parameter, understand the equation in terms of mathematical notation, then try to answer. That is very, 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 very important. Question number 14. They have given the work done in increasing the length of the wire, of area of cross-section 0.1 millimeter square. Of area of cross-section 0.1 millimeter square, the work done in increasing the length of the wire of area of cross-section 0.1 millimeter square by 1% will be dash, provided the Young's modulus is 9 multiplied by 10 power 11 Pascal. Question number 14. The work done is so much dash, provided the increasing area, the length of the wire of area of cross-section A will be equal to 0.1 millimeter square. That is equal to 0.1. multiplied by 10 power minus 3 meter the whole square, and that is equal to 0.1 multiplied by 10 power minus 6 meter square. Okay, and that is your area in terms of the corresponding SI unit. What about the, they have given in length increase is what, 1%, that is delta L by L multiplied by 100 will be equal to 1%. Therefore, what is delta L by L? Will be equal to 1 by 100. Delta L by L is 1 by 100. Please, children, make a note. 1% is multiplied by, that is error in your length or increase in length per original length. Delta L by L into 100 is 1, that is 1%. And when I say 1, children, already percentage is accounted here. Therefore, the pure value of delta L by L will be equal to 1 by 100. Now, they are asking the corresponding, your work done. What is the formula for work done, children? Work done in terms of the extension will be equal to half into stress multiplied by strain, multiplied by volume. Work done will be equal to stress multiplied by strain multiplied by volume. What is your stress, children? Your force by area, F by A. What is strain, children? Strain. They have not given the load. And we have to understand they have given the value of your Y. Y has 9 multiplied by 10 power 11 Pascal. Okay, now we have to convert. Let us not cancel, children. We have to convert in terms of your Y. F by A will be equal to strain is delta L by L. Volume will be equal to area into length. Now, we know that Y will be equal to F by A multiplied by your 1 by delta L by L or L by L. L by delta L or 1 by, that is called strain. This is called stress. Stress by strain is called as Young's modulus. Now, I can understand F by A. Your y into delta l by l will be equal to f by a, because we have been given with area, but we don't know the value of load. So I want to eliminate your L. I want to eliminate your F. When I want to eliminate F in terms of Y, then Y into delta L by L will be equal to F by A. Therefore, W will be equal to half multiplied by, instead of F by A, I'm going to substitute your Y delta L by L. Y into delta L by L multiplied by again delta L by L multiplied by area into your length. Therefore, work done will be equal to your half multiplied by, now this is Y, half multiplied by Y. I don't cancel your L, children, because we know the value only delta L. L is not given. Initial length is not given. You cannot assume any other value. Y multiplied by half into Y multiplied by delta L by L, the whole square multiplied by area into length. Okay. Now, in this, to calculate the work done, we need to have Y. We need to have delta L by L, we have. We need to have A, we have. But we don't know L. How to calculate, children? Work done increasing the length of a wire of, they have not given, they have given the unit. See the unit. The unit is in terms of joule. The work done unit is in terms of joule. When I say it's in terms of joule, then there is no question. This is a total work done. It's a total work done. The total work done is only this formula, children. L is not given. Now assume L as 1. I'm going to assume L as 1. Assuming L as 1 meter. Now it's only assumption, children. I'm not going to justify my answer. I'm going to assume a half into Y into. What is Y, children, value? 9 multiplied by 10 power 11. 9 multiplied by 10 power 11 multiplied by what is delta L by L whole square? 1 by 100 multiplied by 1 by 100. Because that is delta L by L is 1 by 100. 1 by 100 multiplied by 1 by 100. What is A, children? 0.1 multiplied by 10 power minus 6. 0.1 multiplied by 10 power minus 6. And L I assume as 1. Therefore, that is W is equal to 9 by 2. Only these numbers are 9 by 2, 4.5 multiplied by 10 power 11. And the denominator we have got 10 power 4. And the numerator we have again 0.1. This is 10 power minus 1, 10 power minus 7, minus 6, 10 power minus 7. 10 power minus 7 will come into picture. Okay. Now, therefore, work done will be equal to 4.5 multiplied. This goes as 10 power 7, children. 11 minus 4 is 7. 7 minus 7 is 0. Therefore, 10 power 0 is 1. Work done will be equal to 4.5 joule. Work done will be equal to 4.5 joule. Provided we understand your length as what? Provided we understand the length as 1 meter. And they have given the option in the book as 4.5 multiplied by 10 power 10 square. It means the length, initial length should be 100 meter. The initial length should be 100 meter. Because if you multiply by 100, you will get this answer. Don't bother about the answer, children. Don't bother about the answer for the question. Don't bother about the answer for the question. Understand the question in its correct sense. Understand the question in its correct sense. The author made a mistake. I can do mistake. And the author may do mistake. But children, you should not do commit such mistake in the examination. Please understand the question in the correct sense. And definitely, if length is not given, then this particular value of W cannot be worked out. Now, I have assumed length as 1 and got the answer as 4.5 joule. If the length is 100 meter, then the value will be what? Your 4,500 joules. Now, this is total work done. This W is nothing but total work done. Total work done. Now, work done per unit volume. Work done per unit volume is called as U. It is called as U. Work done per unit volume. I divide by volume. When I divide by volume, that is called half into stress into strain. That is equal to half multiplied by stress multiplied by strain. Work done per unit volume. The unit of this is what? Joule per meter cube. The unit of this U is joule per meter cube. So only I just saw the unit of your corresponding often children, but they have not given joule per meter cube. They have given only joule. And then we cannot use this formula for the question number 14. We have to use definitely only this formula for question number 14. And hence the correct answer for the question number 14 is 4.5 joules, provided we understand that the length is 1 meter. Length is 1 meter. I will not say the length is 100 because the data is not being given in the problem, children. That's about the idea of question number 14. Question number 15. The length of the wire increases by L due to a force F. The length of the wire increases by L. Therefore, what does it mean? If the initial length is L1, then the final length is L2. L2 minus L1 is called as what? L2 minus L1 is called as your L. That is delta L. Delta L is called as L. Delta L is called as L. Delta L is called as L. Okay. Right. Now, the length of the wire increases by L due to a force applied on it. Due to a force F applied on it. Then the work done by stretching the wire. Then the work done by stretching the wire will be equal to question number 15. Work done will be equal to total work done. Half multiplied by stress. Multiplied by strain, multiplied by volume. Okay. Now I am going to understand that your F, this is the thing, but F by A, A into L. Now L is the original volume. Maybe I can say L1. What is delta L, children? Delta L is something but L2 minus L1. In this problem, your L2 minus L1 is being given as L. L2 minus L1 is being given as L. Okay. All right. Now, how to go about understanding the length of the wire increases by L due to a force F. Therefore, delta L is L. Delta L is L. Now, they are asking the work done in stretching. Work done in stretching. I can cancel L1, L1. I can cancel A and A. Therefore, W will be equal to half multiplied by F into delta L. What is delta L, children? That is L. Therefore, W will be equal to half multiplied by F into L. That is nothing but W will be equal to FL by 2. FL by 2, that is the total work done. It is not the work done per unit volume. If it is unit volume, then you divide by volume, children. The answer is FL by 2. And the correct option for the question number 15 is option C. Option C is the correct option for question number 15. Question number 16. Two wires made of same material. Children, same material. What does it imply? It implies Y is constant. Same material. What does it imply? It implies Young's modulus is constant. That is Y is constant. Y is constant. Please register. When we read something, please register the corresponding the nature, children. Question number 16. We have given two materials, two wires of are made of same material and are the same volume. Same material. It means what? It means your Young's modulus is same. And they have given same volume. It means what? V1 will be equal to V2. That is area 1 multiplied by length 1 will be equal to area 2 multiplied by length 2. That is the area, same volume. They have given same volume. V1 should be equal to V2. The relationship is area into length is volume. Therefore, A1 multiplied by L1 will be equal to A2 multiplied by L2. Okay? Right. Now, the first wire has a cross-section area A. And the second wire has a cross-section area 3A. The first wire has a cross-section area A multiplied by L1. Second wire has a cross-section area 3A multiplied by L2. Therefore, your A and A gets cancelled. L1 will be equal to what? 3 times of L2. L1 will be equal to 3 times of L2. Or L2 will be equal to your corresponding L1 by 3. L2 will be equal to L1 by 3, whatever may be. Maybe I can say L2 will be equal to L1 divided by 3. Okay? Right. Now, what is the required answer, children? It's a question number 16 is NEET 2018. If the length of the first wire is increased by delta L, applying the force F, we are applying for the first wire, we are applying the force F, the change in length is what? Delta L, okay? Now, how much force is required for the second wire, so that how much force is needed to stretch the second wire by the same amount? We want the force, your F1, in the second case, maybe I can say your F1 here, F2, and the F1 is being given as what? F. F1 is being given as F. F1 is being given as F. Okay. And that is for the first case. They want to put the same change in length. Okay. Now, Y is same. Therefore, Y will be equal to F by A multiplied by L by delta L. L by delta L. F by A multiplied by L by delta L. And I'm going to use the corresponding variable, children. Your Y1 will be equal to Y2. This implies F1 by A1. Into L1 by delta L. Delta L is same for both. Delta L is same for both. Okay. Right. That will be equal to corresponding F2 by A2 by L2 divided by the delta L. Okay. Now, the value of F1 is F multiplied by L1. L1 is the relationship between L1 and L2. L1 and L2 is what? L1. L2 is L1 by 3. Or L1 is 3 L2 multiplied by 3 L2 divided by what is your corresponding A, though we don't know the area. We know that area between 3 times is A and that is 3A. Therefore, I put A multiplied by delta L. Delta L is constant. F2 to find and A2 is 3A. 3A multiplied by L2. Here 3 L2 and here simply L2 because L1 is 3 times of L2. L1, I have substituted L1 as 3 times of L2. And what about delta L? Delta L is constant for both. Therefore, cancelling delta L, cancelling A and A. And therefore, we have your L2 also I can cancel. I have 3F will be equal to F2 by 3. I have 3F will be equal to F2 by 3. Therefore, F2 will be equal to 9F. F2 will be equal to 9F. And that is one of the methods, children, doing the problem. I have just equated the Young's modulus. Now, we can even understand in terms of your corresponding equation with respect to A and L. We can understand here. Maybe I can do the same thing in terms of other method, Y will be equal to F by A multiplied by L by delta L. Here, Y is constant and delta L is constant. Therefore, Y into delta L equal to constant F into L by A. F into L by A. We want F. This is constant K. Therefore, K will be equal to F into L by A. Therefore, your F is proportional to A by L. Or I can say your F2 by F1. F2 by F1 will be equal to A2 by L1, A2 by L2 divided by A1 by L1, A2 by L2 divided by A1 by L1. Therefore, F2 divided by F2 by F, F1 is F. This is nothing but A2 by A1 multiplied by your L1 by L2, A2 by A1 multiplied by L1 by L2. What is your A2, children? It is 3 times of A. What is A1, children? It is A. A1 is nothing but A, okay? multiplied by what is L1 children? 3 times of L2. 3 times of L2 divided by L2 is L2. And therefore, cancelling A, we have got again F2 by F will be equal to 3 times of 3, 9. Therefore, F2 by F is 9, which is equal to 9. We can do the constancy method. We can do the constancy method like this. Or we can go by the method with respect to what? You are equating the Young's modulus. Both are same children. In the second case, I have identified all the constants and done the problem. The question number 16, the correct option is option C. Option C is the correct option for question number 16. Question number 17. A good lubricant should have a first option. They have given high viscosity. And then second option, your low viscosity. When I say low viscosity children, obviously it cannot act like a good lubricant because low viscosity can easily flow. High viscosity can remain between two parts. If you have two metal parts and if you pour water, water will immediately flow. Whereas if you pour some oil will stay there for some time. And therefore, for that purpose only, lubricants are used in terms of engine oils. In terms of engine oils, the lubricants are your oil, but not your engine water lubricant. We don't have water lubricant for engine children. We have only oil lubricant. Therefore, low viscosity is ruled out. Moderate viscosity, that's also ruled out. High density. Density is nothing but mass by volume, children. Density does not have a direct correlation with respect to your idea of your lubricant. And high viscosity is the correct answer. For efficient lubrication, your viscosity should be high. Thermal stability should be high. Viscosity should be high. Thermal stability should be high. Corresponding boiling point of the system should be also very high. Please note these three points for good lubricant, your efficiency, that is viscosity, should be high, eta. And then thermal stability should withstand high temperature. And because of friction, more heat will be developed and it has to withstand high temperature. And obviously, boiling point should also be very high. If the boiling point is low, it will evaporate. And therefore, the correct option for the question number 17 is option A. Question number 18. In which of the following cases, the liquid flow in a pipe be most streamlined? In which of the following cases, the liquid flow in the pipe will be most streamlined? Children, we have the number called Reynolds number. It is rho Vd divided by eta. Reynolds number is rho Vd by eta. Rho Vd by eta. And if the Reynolds number is less than, I would say some book they would have given 2000 and some book they would have given 2000. Okay. If the Reynolds number is 1000 or 1500, definitely it is highly streamlined. If it is low, streamlined. If it is very high, then it is your turbulent motion. If it is in between your 2000 to 3000, then it is called as a neither a streamline nor a turbulent motion. And therefore, Reynolds number decides about your streamline and turbulent. If it is low, it is streamline. If it is high, it is called turbulent motion. Now, how to understand the value in terms of the corresponding parameter, children? When density is high, Reynolds number will be very high. But we want the most will be streamlined. For streamlined, numerator should be low. Therefore, density low, critical velocity should be low, and diameter should be, pipe should be low. And denominator should be very high. Viscosity should be very high. And therefore, for NR to be low, rho Vd should be low, and eta should be high. Okay, this is the condition. And hence, the first option, your liquid of high viscosity, correct. Correct. And high density, D is diameter, children. High density is wrong. Rho is density. High density is wrong. Ruled out. B, liquid of high viscosity, low density, flowing through the pipe of small radius. Diameter small, correct. Density small, correct. And high viscosity, correct. Option B should be the correct answer, children. Let us analyze option C and D. Low viscosity, wrong. Again, D, low viscosity, wrong. Therefore, option C and D are ruled out because of low viscosity. Viscosity should be higher here. And then the correct option for the question number 18. Is option B. Question number 19. Two water pipes of diameters D1 is being given as your 2 cm and D2 as 4 cm. Your diameter D1 will be equal to 2 cm and diameter D2 is 4 cm. The diameter being given as 2 and 4 cm, children, are connected with the main steam pipeline. The velocity of the flow of water in the pipe 2 cm is dash. We want the velocity of the pipe of flow in the 2 cm. The velocity of flow of water in the pipe 2 cm. Let me call this is V1, this is V2. They want V1 is equal to how much times of V2. They want V1 will be equal to how much times of V2. That is the idea of your question, children. Now, equation of continuity. In the equation of continuity, there is a particular, in the equation of continuity, please understand that your area multiplied by velocity is equal to constant. Equation of continuity says that area multiplied by velocity is constant. Area multiplied by velocity is constant. What is area, children? Your in terms of diameter, pi d square by 4. Pi d square by 4 multiplied by velocity will be equal to constant. Will be equal to constant. Therefore, pi by 4 is constant. D square v will be equal to constant. D square v will be equal to constant. What does it imply, children? D1 square multiplied by V1 will be equal to D2 square multiplied by V2. Therefore, we want the value of children. V1 will be equal to D2 square divided by D1 square multiplied by V2. What is children? Don't worry about the unit, because again square unit centimeter square will cancel. 4 square 2 square multiplied by V2. D2 square is 4 and D1 square is 2. Therefore, V1 will be equal to 16 by 4 multiplied by V2. Therefore, V1 is 4 times of V2. V1, the velocity in the lower diameter will be 4 times of V2, children. And then the correct option for the question number 19 is option A, 4 times option A, 4 times that in the other pipe. Option A, 4 times that in the other pipe. That's about the idea of question number 19, children. Question number 20. We have got theoretical idea of the question number 20, children. Now, aerofoils are so designed that the speed of air on top is more than the bottom. On top is less than that of the bottom. Speed is same both sides, and the corresponding speed is turbulent. Children, when I say aerofoil, it has to fly above. It has to fly above. And therefore, for flying above, your P2 at the bottom, that is velocity at the bottom. Velocity at the bottom should be higher than the velocity, sorry, pressure at the bottom should be higher than the pressure at the top. Pressure at the top should be less than pressure at the bottom. Then only it can fly. Then only it can move above. Then only it can flow. It can just raise and then fly. Therefore, when pressure is more, velocity should be opposite. P is inversely proportional to V, children. Here in this case, please understand, when pressure is more, velocity should be of your opposite sign. And therefore, velocity at the top should be more than velocity at the bottom. Velocity at the top should be more than velocity at the bottom, children. We have got the inverse relationship between your pressure and volume. Sorry, pressure and your corresponding velocity. The speed is opposite with respect to pressure, and hence we have aerofoils that are so arranged, so designed that the speed of air on the top is more than the corresponding bottom. And then the correct option for the question number 20 is option A. Option A is the correct option for question number 20. Question number 21. A wind with a speed of 40 meter per second blows parallel to the roof. Okay, right. Now, the velocity is outside is what? Your wind velocity outside the roof. That is your V2. Or I can say, understand, outside. Outside velocity is V2. And the outside velocity is V out. And inside velocity is 0. Because wind will not flow that much. With the same speed, it will not flow inside. And therefore, inside velocity of the wind will be nearly 0. Assuming that the hut is closed. Okay. Now, therefore, children, for the question number 21, let us try to extract all the data. We have got a roof. We have got a roof, and the speed outside is 40 meter per second. We can understand outside as 40 meter per second. Yes, the speed outside is 40 meter per second. Speed inside is said to be what? You are said to be 0, children, because the flow of your air will not be inside. Like outside will not be inside. Relatively, it's what? 0 meter per second. Okay, right. And the surface area of the roof that is being given as your 250 meter square. The surface area is 250 meter square. The surface area is 250 meter square. Okay, right. Maybe we can even assume that the roof is what? Almost straight, children. Because when I say roof is straight, then we can understand that potential energy is constant. When I say roof is straight, then the potential energy remains constant. In both the cases, the potential energy remains constant. Only the pressure energy and kinetic energy will vary. Don't worry about that. Even this small difference, potential energy will not vary. Okay, that is not a problem. And assuming that the pressure inside the house is 1 atmosphere. Inside pressure is 1 atmosphere. Okay. Right. Pressure inside the house is 1 atmosphere. And what about the force exerted by the wind on the roof and the direction of the force. Force exerted by the wind on the roof. So therefore, we have got the corresponding roof. The wind exert, because we have got some velocity here, we have got velocity different here. velocity at the top is higher than velocity at the bottom. Therefore, P out will be more less than what? P in. P out will be less than P in. Therefore, your things will move about. That is, it will increase the, it will throw away the roof. Therefore, children, now your P in plus corresponding the kinetic energy inside, half m V I square will be equal to P out plus the corresponding again half m V out square. Okay. Now here I am assuming that potential energy remains constant in both the cases. Inside and outside, the average potential energy is what? Same. The average potential energy is same, children. Therefore, I am not taking the MGH value, MGH value. The average potential energy remains same because root will be at the same level. Roof will be at the same level. Therefore, your minus P2, your half M V naught square minus half M V I square. Children, V I square is zero because V I is zero. Therefore, V I square is zero. There is nothing but change in pressure. Change in pressure will be equal to half into now mass multiplied by corresponding your V naught square. Children, half multiplied by, have they given the mass? They have given density. They have given density of air. They have not given the mass. Okay. They have given density. And we can assume that this is nothing but your this pressure energy. Pressure energy, please understand, children. Your this is nothing but your in terms of per unit mass. In terms of unit mass or unit volume, this is pressure energy equation in terms of unit volume. In terms of unit volume, in terms of mass, I have given there. Now, for understanding in terms of your unit volume, I am going to divide. I am going to divide your in divide by density, divide by corresponding density. Therefore, your R volume. When I divide by volume, mass by volume will become density. Children, therefore, pressure, your change in pressure, P in PI by P naught divided by volume, will be equal to, that is change in pressure per unit volume. Change in pressure per unit volume will be equal to half into M by V, that is volume multiplied by V naught square plus zero or minus zero. This term will be zero. Why is this term zero? Because already zero by V is zero. Now, your pressure energy, the change in pressure is nothing but pressure energy. The change in pressure per unit volume is also pressure energy per unit volume. That is also pressure energy per unit volume. Therefore, pressure energy per unit volume will be equal to half into rho into, that is M by V is nothing but rho. Since mass is not given, we have been given the density. We have been given the density as what? Your equation, your density value is 1.2 kg per meter cube. Density of air is being given as 1.2 kg per meter cube. Therefore, I am going to convert in terms of the mass as density, children. Mass multiplied by mass divided by volume is called density. And therefore, pressure energy per unit volume will be equal to what? Half rho V naught square. That is equal to half into, what is your rho, children? Rho will be 1.2, half into 1.2 multiplied by V naught. V naught is 40 multiplied by 40. 40 multiplied by 40. Therefore, this becomes your 1600 or 20. 800 multiplied by 1.2. 1.2 multiplied by 800. 8 multiplied by 12. It is your 9.6. 9.6 multiplied by corresponding your 800. It's nothing but 960. Therefore, the pressure energy per unit volume is what? 960. The pressure energy or the pressure contributed inside, the change in pressure inside is nothing but 960. What about the force, children? Force will be equal to corresponding change in pressure multiplied by your area, multiplied by area. Force will be equal to, we know that pressure will be equal to change in pressure multiplied by area. We know that pressure will be equal to force by area. And therefore, force will be equal to pressure into area, children. And then your pressure, change in pressure is nothing but pressure here. Difference in pressure, that can be understood with respect to unit volume. And let us check the unit, children. When we check the unit, obviously they have given only in terms of Newton. Absolutely not a problem, because we are going to calculate force and we are going to calculate pressure energy in terms of unit volume. The equation will take into account the equation of this expression, half rho V square will take into account the corresponding unit, children. And therefore, your delta P is nothing but 960 multiplied by A is nothing but 250. 960 multiplied by 250. Approximately, I can keep this as 1000. 1000 means 3 zeros are there. And your this 4 zeros are there, 10 power 5. 25 multiplied by 25, 3 plus 1, 4. 25 multiplied by 10 power 4. Approximately, it is 25 multiplied by 10 power. This 1000, 1000, 3 zeros are there. Again, your, I'm going to keep this as 1000. When I keep this as 1000, it will become approximately 3 zeros. 3 multiplied by your 250 multiplied by 1000, it is nothing but 2.5 lakhs. 2.5 lakhs. 2.5 lakhs is what? Obviously, it is nothing but 2.5 multiplied by 10 power 5. 2.5 multiplied 25 multiplied by 10 power 4 or 2.5 multiplied by 10 power 5. Nearest answer is what? Your option C, children. Option C, the direction is upward because the inner pressure is higher, velocity above and velocity here low. Velocity at the top is less than, is more than velocity at the bottom. Then what does it imply? Pressure at the top will be less than pressure at the bottom. Then what does it imply? Bottom pressure is higher, therefore it will get lifted upwards. It move upwards. And hence, the correct option, nearest option will be 2.4 multiplied by 10 power 5 Newton upwards. And hence, the correct option for the question number 21 is option C. Correct option for the question number 21 is option C. Children, with respect to Bernoulli's equation, please try to understand. You have got different equations of Bernoulli. It is with respect to your energy conserved, with respect to per unit mass, with respect to per unit volume, with respect to unit density. Okay, or you can have specific energy. Specific means divided by mass. Or you can have in terms of your pressure energy or the energy with respect to unit volume. Divide by volume. When we divide by volume, then mass and volume, your m by v will become rho. Therefore, you will be given in the standard textbook some two or three forms of Bernoulli's equation. Please try to register that. And if at all you have any doubt, please feel free to ask me at any point of time. We will clear the doubt. Puridapa? Everybody? Did you all understand? Okay, children, as of now, that's all. Evening around 3 or 3:15, we'll meet for a chemistry class, periodic classification, and then you will have test in the evening. Bye-bye, children. Bye. Thank you for listening to the class.